Good morning. Welcome to the fourth Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today we celebrate the 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today, across the Archdiocese, there will be a second collection for the Clergy Trust. The Clergy Trust supports the retirement, medical, and financial needs of priests in the Archdiocese of Boston. Thank you in advance for your generosity and your support. We remember today in a special way at this Eucharist, Chris Boris, the presider of the Mass is Father Mike Doyle, assisted by Deacon Powers. The Eucharistic minister is Tony Conti, the cantor is Brian Landry, and the keyboardist is Mara Lynch.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Pardon me. Our opening hymn today is in your Breaking Bread hymnal. It's number 739, Lead Me, Lord. Please stand for our processional hymn, number 739.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, longing for their Lord. For God's coming kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are the sorrowing, for they shall be consoled. And the meek shall come to rule the world. Find the narrow way. Be my way, be my truth, be my life, my Lord, and lead me, Lord, today. Blessed are the merciful, for mercy shall be theirs, and the pure in heart shall see their God. Blessed are they whose hunger only holiness can fill, for I say they shall be satisfied. Lead me, Lord, lead me, Lord, by the light of truth, to seek and to find the narrow.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
With your spirit.
My friends, as we gather to celebrate the Eucharist, we come before the Lord humble and contrite of heart.
You have come to heal a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth.
Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. He is near who upholds my right. If anyone wishes to oppose me, let us appear together. Who disputes my right? Let that man confront me. See, the Lord God is my help. Who will prove me wrong? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I love the Lord because he has heard my voice in supplication. Because he has inclined his ear to me the day I called. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. The cords of death encompassed me, the snares of the netherworld seized upon me. I fell into distress and sorrow, and I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, save my life. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Gracious is the Lord and just. Yes, our God is merciful. The Lord keeps the little ones. I was brought low, and he saved me. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
A reading from the letter of St. James. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can that faith save him? If a brother or sister has nothing to wear and has no food for the day, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat well, but you do not give them the necessities of the body, what good is it? See also, faith of itself, if it does not have works, is dead. Indeed, someone might say, you have faith and I have works. Demonstrate your faith to me without works, and I will demonstrate my faith to you from my works. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Let your heart rejoice in the Lord. Let your word proclaim his deeds. Let your voice sing out to the world that our God has come to save. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus and his disciples set out for the villages of Caesarea Philippi. Along the way, he asked his disciples, who do people say that I am? They said in reply, John the Baptist, others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets. And he asked them, but who do you say that I am? Peter said to him in reply, you are the Christ. Then he warned them not to tell anyone about him. He began to teach that the Son of Man must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed and rise after 3 days. He spoke this openly. Then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. At this he turned around, looking at his disciples, rebuked Peter and said, get behind me, Satan. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. He summoned the crowd with his disciples and said to them, whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake and that of the gospel will save it. The Gospel of the Lord.
We all form perceptions of other people based upon our experience of them, as well as on our own past experiences of other people and relationships. At times, we can project things onto others that come from us and which might have very little or anything to do with the other person. A psychiatrist once suggested, for instance, that what we call being in love is, in effect, a kind of transference psychosis, meaning we adopt this idealized image of another person that excludes any possibility that they might have a flaw or shortcomings or peccadilloes. It's a delusion, of course, that might have some basis in reality, but on the whole is a distortion, a quasi-mirage, so to speak. There is something there, but our perception is distorted and inaccurate. I share this with you because this is what is going on in the gospel this morning. Peter and the disciples have a very distorted idea of who Jesus is. While Peter correctly identifies Jesus as the Messiah, the anointed of the Lord, he is deluded about the kind of Messiah that Jesus is. Peter wants Jesus to be a Messiah who is akin to Judas Maccabee in the Old Testament, a conquering hero kind of Messiah who delivers Israel from oppression and bondage. The idea that Jesus would be rejected and ultimately put to death was anathema to Peter because, as Jesus points out to him, he is thinking as humans do, and not as God does. Because Jesus is aligned with God, he is resolved to carry out the mission that God has entrusted to him, even if it means submitting to the cross and death. In the New Testament, there are two kinds of death, so to speak. There is death with a capital D and death with a small or lowercase d. You might call them big death and little death. Little death is physical death. It's the end of our earthly existence. Jesus really wasn't concerned about little death too much. Big death is spiritual death. It's the death of the soul, if you will. This is a death that Jesus wanted his followers and his listeners to be really, really concerned about. This is why Jesus admonishes his followers not to be afraid of someone who can destroy their body. Instead, he says, fear the one who can cast both body and soul into Gehenna. From Jesus' perspective, earthly life is fleeting, transitory, temporary. Eternity, on the other hand, is forever. Jesus is suggesting that it is only in losing ourselves, in order to find our true selves in him, that we can ultimately save ourselves. He makes it clear as well that being willing to embrace the cross and follow him are essential for discipleship. In this scene in the gospel, we are seeing Peter both at his best and at his worst. He is able to profess faith that Jesus indeed is the Messiah, but he doesn't have a clue about what Jesus' messiahship actually means, what it is about. Ultimately, Peter will figure it out, and like all of the other apostles except for two, he will sacrifice his life, lay down his life for Jesus and the gospel, in his case, being crucified upside down because he did not regard himself worthy to die the way that Jesus did. So ultimately, Peter was willing to experience the cross and death for his allegiance to Christ. St. Richard prayed that he might be able to see Jesus more clearly, love him more dearly, and follow him more nearly. That's what this gospel is about this morning. Seeing Jesus is the Messiah that he is, and not the Messiah that he is not. Not a powerful, vanquishing, political Messiah, but God's suffering servant who seeks to overcome all of the evil of the world through his cross and death on Calvary. The other part, of course, is about our being willing to embrace the cross ourselves so that we can discover in Christ not merely the continuation of physical life, survival, if you will, but the fullness of life that Christ offers us each day instead. May God quicken our steps in our efforts to both seek this Christ and follow him ever more closely. To the Lord God, who always helps us, let us pray in the name of Jesus, God's servant.
That all who confess Jesus as Messiah may take up the cross and follow Jesus by sacrificing themselves for the sake of the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that those who set their faces against this world's injustices may confront worldly powers with unconquerable witness of truth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and hungry may find in the hearts of Christians a faith that manifests itself in the practical care and concern for their needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work in business and finance may find the courage to bear witness to honesty and integrity above human profit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this community's profession of faith in Jesus the Messiah may take flesh in practical works of charity for those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the departed whose lives on earth were spent in the service of Christ, especially Chris Borhars, for whom this is a memorial mass, as well as Leonard Kelly, Joseph McKern, Janine Ouellet, may follow Christ now to the salvation promised in the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Make us one, O God, in acknowledging Jesus the Christ. As we proclaim him by our words, let us follow him in our works. Give us strength to take up the cross and courage to lose our lives for his sake. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our song for the preparation of the gifts is number 461, Send Us Your Spirit.
Loving free, hear us and help us, O Lord.
that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God the Almighty and compassionate Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. By the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have been with you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The world of love.
Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen. There are two announcements for this week. First, our parish annual report is now available. Please see our website or pick one up at the main entrance to the church. Also, come and get them. Tickets for our collaborative lawn party on September 22nd are available after Mass today. Tickets are $5 a person with a maximum of $25 per family. Come and join us next week. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. You may go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing song is number 436, Though the Mountains May Fall.
Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand. Sing the praise and the glory of God. Would the Lord ever leave you? Would the Lord forget his love? Oh, a mother forsake her child, he will not abandon you. Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand. As a shelter for all who will call on his name, sing the praise and the glory of God. Should you turn and forsake him, he will gently call your name. Should you wander away from him, he will always take you back. Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand. For all who will call on his name, sing the praise and the glory of God.
Thanks, folks. Have a great week. Walking the light.